Scafflogic introduces you to a world of logic. Hello and welcome back to the world of Scafflogic. In today's video, our topic is how to work with cross-sectional views. In this presentation, I will be using Lyer Speedy Scaff, and if you're using a different scaffold brand, you may notice some slight differences. As you can see, I have already built up a scaffold around a building, and there are different components on it. Today I would like to show you a rather handy function which will enable you to cut different kinds of views. In our toolbar, located at the top of the screen, we have three sections associated with cross-sectional view. The first is for adding, the second for editing, and the third for deleting. Let's place it on the desktop by clicking one of the functions and make adjustments to the camera. First, we'll select our viewpoint, and then we'll decide on the depth of the camera view. As you can see here, the camera will now look directly from this angle into the scaffold. We can place as many cross-sectional views as we want, and place them in all the different angles that we want. You can even use this technique to produce some rather good blueprint drawings. So, here we have S1, here is S2, and here is S3, each one representing a cross-sectional view. Let's go into the elevation menu to get a better look. In elevation mode, we see three extra tab pages at the top, and as we click each one, we get a different view. We can zoom in on these views, and we can also print them off automatically to be used as working drawings. Another great feature about this function is that you can place objects directly on the scaffold, whether it is a joint scaffold or a single section. Using the content menu, you can place additional equipment or anything that you need just by right-clicking and adding what you want. If we jump to 3D view, we can see the two workers we have added. And if we want to create a zoom, we can go back into the plan drawing, click on cross-sectional view, and make a view that we will call S4. And let's have a look. From this view, we can get a good look at how the outside console is hanging. If you need to remove one of the views, you simply left-click on it, and it will be deleted instantly. Remember to press Escape to get out of the menu. Finally, you can change the depth on the cross-sectional view by touching the corners, making it wider or more narrow. And again, remember to push the Escape key to get out.